If I had no sickness, no problem, and nothing negative at all in my life, no test whatsoever, do you really think I would be able to worship Allah sincerely without shedding tears and so on? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws us closer to Him through the tests that He places in our life. This is why the weakness of man is such that when he has no test, he sometimes is led astray by the devil. He's so happy because to him he is in a little paradise. But when Allah loves him, Allah taps him with a test and with some negativity. So in a few moments, the person begins to call out to Allah, "Ya Allah, help me! What made you call out to Allah? It is because you have a problem today that you turn to me. Allahu Akbar. I gave you the problem because I love you so much that I wanted you to come close to me. Now that you are coming closer, you are crying for me. You have got up early morning when everyone is asleep and you are worshipping me so sincerely because you have a health problem. I think I'm going to keep you in this condition because you are so, so close to me. Allahu Akbar." But we would say, "That's not fair, O Allah. How can you keep me sick and ill? I'm calling out to you." But Allah says, "As soon as I return your health to you, you may go back and you may forget about me." Verses of the Quran prove this, subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. This is why it is reported that a person who has been tested and afflicted with the tests such as health matters and sickness, when they see the great massive reward on the day of judgment, they will say, "Oh Allah, why didn't you keep us sick for the rest of our lives? Subhanallah. Why didn't you keep us ill or in that condition for longer? We came so close to you. Our status was elevated." My brothers and sisters, the answer is sabr. Bear patience. Remember, bear patience. It is Allah's plan. Ultimately, I have to return to Allah. May Allah make it easy the day He chooses to take me away or you away. Ameen. May He make it easy for us. It is of utmost importance to also note, and I mentioned it, I am repeating it with detail. To be happy with the decree of Allah that Allah has chosen for you that you are sometimes unable to do anything about. The sooner you surrender to the decree of Allah, the quicker you will be able to become closer to Allah and you will be able to understand the plan of Allah in this world, and the sooner you will be able to continue with the rest of the short life that you have. Let me give you a little example. At the moment, the Ummah at large, humanity at large, and every sane human being on the globe is very concerned about what has happened to the Malaysian Airlines MH370. We are all praying, we all make dua, we feel the pain of those who are affected, and really we call out to Allah to help them and to help those who have been on that particular aircraft. What has happened, none of us may know. And perhaps we may never know. At the moment, there is a lot of guesswork that is going on. We ask Allah to safeguard us. We ask Allah to protect us. We shed tears in solidarity with those who are affected. But remember one thing. Ultimately, we have to surrender to the decree of Allah. Allah loves those more than we will ever be able to love them. Allah knows where they are. Allah is the one who is responsible. Allah created them in the first place. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept it as a huge test for all of us. How is this going to affect your life positively? That is one item for certain that we can take away from the entire episode whilst calling out to Allah, "Ya Allah, Ya Allah, return them to us miraculously." Ameen. Ya Allah, return them to us miraculously. You are the owner of miracles, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you every form of goodness and ease for them and their families and for us all as an ummah. My brothers and sisters, what a big test. What a great test. The magnitude of the test. Each one in our lives goes through different tests. At the moment, we stand in solidarity with all the others. Remember, the day you have a test, the others will stand in solidarity with you. So it is up to you to make sure you utter responsible statements. You have hope in the mercy of Allah. We are mu'mineen, we believe in Allah. We believe Allah created in the first place. He is the owner. He is in absolute control of everything. It is Allah and Allah alone. And we also understand the term rida bil qada. To be happy at the decree of Allah. To be able to say, Ya Allah, you have chosen this for me, Ya Allah. I will not compete with your choice and your decision. Ya Allah, help me. I am weak. I am a human being. I try my best, Ya Allah. There is a limited capacity I have. Ya Allah, help me. Help me. Grant me a greater capacity, Ya Allah. Help me through these tests that I am going through. My brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to create ease for us. Many of us have gone through so many issues, so many difficulties. Let me read for you one verse before I close. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Allah says, we will definitely test all of you with a little bit of fear, with a little bit of hunger. These are different departments we can speak about, but I'm leaving it brief. We will test all of you with a little bit of fear, in whatever way it is, with a little bit of hunger, in whatever way it is, and in loss of wealth, loss of produce, loss of life. So you will definitely lose someone who is loved by you at some stage in your life, because Allah says that is part of your test. You have to be asked that question. It is like Allah asking us 1 + 1. We have to know the answer. Allahu Akbar. We have to know the answer. Allah says, it is impossible for you not to have lost someone who is very, very close to you in your life, or you will be lost by those who love you equally. Allahu Akbar. So that is part of your test. The sooner you realize that this is returning to a better life, returning to our Maker, the eternal bliss, the life where there is no death thereafter, that is where they have gone and that is where we will go, those whom we love. May Allah make it easy for us to surrender to reality. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for every one of us and make it easy for those whom we will be leaving behind the day we die. Brothers and sisters, these are just part of the tests of Allah. That verse continues where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, give good news to those who bear sabr. Those whom, when they are informed of damaging news, when they are informed of news that is within the decree of Allah, when they are tested in that particular way, they are quick to utter the declaration, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We indeed belong to Allah. We were always His. We came from Him. And we are all going to return exactly to the same Maker. May Allah make it easy for us all. And may Allah open our doors, brothers and sisters. This life is but temporary. Your problem will not last forever. The loss or the debt that you are in will never last forever. The issue that you have will not last forever. It will come to pass and it will come to an end by the will of Allah. Continue calling out to Allah without losing hope. Continue trying to please your Maker. He knows you. He watches you. He is in control. He knows why He has tested you in a specific way. That is your test by the will of Allah. When you have your certificate at the end, you will be granted paradise, eternal bliss. May Allah unite us in paradise. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.